Panhandler returns Diamond Ring to its owner, but is surprised by her reaction to it. A kind heart makes an individual even more attractive. A soul filled with compassion and respect for others is invincible, even when confronted by hardships. But sometimes your kindness takes you to the places you never expect. Bill Ray, a beggar, helped a woman in getting her ring back, not knowing his selfless act was going to turn his life upside down. Sometimes, some actions have the most unexpected reactions. Sarah felt as if her world had come crashing down when she realized that her engagement ring was missing. Her ring was missing from the moment she gave a small gift to a homeless man. She found herself at her wit's end. Losing your engagement ring is a big blow to anyone. Not only are they close to your heart, but also come expensive. The owner of Darling Yoga Studio, Sarah Darling, loved her engagement ring made of diamond, and losing it was nothing short of a trauma for her. She would never take it off. And now the ring was gone. For once, the woman took it off her hand as she had injured her finger the day before. She put the ring in her bag for safekeeping until the time her finger heals. She thought her bag would be the safest place for the ring. She felt guilty after taking it off, but she had to, for its own safety. She couldn't have been more wrong. While heading back to work, she passed by a homeless person. The woman thought of giving something to the man. She reached for the loose change in her bag and gave it to the beggar. Thereafter, Sarah kept on walking without giving it a second thought. At that time, Sarah could not realize that her ring was missing. It was after some time she learned that her ring was not there in her purse. Sarah recalled, "It was horrible. It was such a feeling of loss. It meant so much to me beyond just the financial value." Sarah tried to recall where she could have lost her ring. She suspected that she might have lost her ring while giving some change to the homeless man. She remembered that was the only time she had opened her bag in the entire day. She decided to meet the guy again. Maybe Sarah had scooped the ring along with a change from her bag and dropped it in the homeless man's cup. She hadn't looked at the change when she was giving it away. The notion took her breath away. So was her ring gone for good? Well, the chances of getting the ring back were next to nothing. However, she decided to give it a try. She kept on praying and hoping to find the man in the spot. In a matter of a few minutes, Sarah found herself back in the same place. Unfortunately, the beggar was nowhere to be seen. The man wasn't there. She wondered if she was ever going to see him again. Sarah had no hope now. She returned home, dejected and distressed. She told her husband about it with tears in her eyes. Her husband, Bill, consoled her and told her to look for the same guy at the same place. So she went there again in the hopes of finding him. Fortunately, the guy was there. He was standing at the same spot with the same cup. Sarah had never felt so relieved on seeing someone. She paced towards him and said, "I don't know if you remember me, but I think I gave you something that's very precious to me." The homeless man's reply brought tears to her eyes. He asked, "Was it a ring?" "Yeah, I have it. I kept it for you." Sarah was happy and surprised both. She had not expected him to keep the ring. In fact, she thought he would have sold it off for some money. Most people would do that. However, this man was clearly different. Sarah wanted to thank him but could not find the right word. The woman had run out of words. Tears were rolling down her cheek when she took back the ring. She thanked him, but she knew that was not going to show him how grateful she was. She thought of doing something big for him. The name of the panhandler was Billy Ray Harris. He was a 55-year-old homeless man. The guy had been homeless for many, many years. A particular road corner in Kansas City was his residence. The man would sleep there at night and would spend days with a cup in his hand and asking passersby for change. The man found himself on the road to fend for his own about 16 years ago. He has struggled a lot to survive each day. Anyone in his situation would try to make most of each and every chance coming his way. Naturally, he thought of selling the ring when he found it in his cup. The man contacted local jewelers to know the worth of the ring. Well, the amount he was told got him by surprise. The jeweler offered $4,000 in exchange for the ring. However, Billy did not sell it off because he doubted it was worth a lot more than the local jeweler had told him. The jeweler tried hard to negotiate with him, but the man decided not to sell him. He had his reasons. Though the man wanted money badly, he could not sell the expensive ring. He doubted that someone had accidentally dropped a ring in his cup. What if the person comes back tomorrow? What will he tell him or her? Even though the ring would have provided him with enough money, his conscience did not allow him to do that. Billy Ray just could not sell the ring. His kindness was what set him apart from other people. As he thought, a lady did come to him asking about the ring a few days later. That was the moment he felt proud of himself for not trading the ring in for some money. Billy gave the ring back to her. It was a good moment. He said, "I just couldn't do it. I'm not saying I'm an angel, but I'm not a devil either." Billy told the woman, "I could tell exactly how much it meant to you as soon as I held it up." Sarah said, "It just makes you realize there are good people out there." Billy controlled his temptation for someone he did not even know. The man, despite his unfavorable condition, decided to save the ring for someone he didn't even know. Sarah was indeed very lucky that she lost her ring to a man like Billy. As said earlier, merely saying thank you was not enough for Sarah to show how much she respected the man. The couple planned on doing something big in order to repay the old man. They wanted to help him the way he helped Sarah when she needed it the most. Sarah explained, "It was just such a feeling of loss when it was gone, so I'm eternally grateful for him." After a lot of wondering and pondering, the couple decided to plan a fundraiser for Billy. They kicked off the work by creating a GoFundMe page with the aim of collecting $1,000. According to the couple, this was the least he deserved for his honesty. The couple, who were deeply impressed by the old man, thought of sharing their experience with the world. They took to the internet and posted their story. And, well, the post received reactions from all over the world. What's more, donations too kept coming in. Billy had won over many hearts. Sarah and Bill had created the page with the intention of collecting enough money for the man to pay for his meals and new clothes. Sarah explained, "We set it up because a lot of people that were touched by this story expressed interest in helping Billy Ray. We set the goal for $1,000 and we're hoping to achieve maybe $4,000 because that is what he was offered on the spot for the ring." The donations did not stop flowing in. The tale warmed many hearts, and that is why a lot of people came forward to assist in raising the cash. The old man went on to make headlines for his act of kindness. At the beginning of establishing the page, Sarah and Bill hoped to raise $1,000 for him. In an amazing turn of events, the couple, in a span of 3 months, managed to gather over $190,000 donated by more than 8,000 individuals. People didn't only donate money, but also admired the man for his generosity. Whereas some kept on admiring him, there were other people who shared their own experience. One person from England wrote, "In life, what goes around comes around. Billy, your sweet actions, despite being in dire straits yourself, prove that there is humility in the world. You are one shining example. Lots of love from across the pond." Another contributor shared his personal experience. "Several years ago, my mother's ring was stolen from my house. To this day, I recall the empty feeling in the pit of my stomach. Hopefully, your honest example will encourage others to pay it forward. Kudos to you, Billy Ray." Sarah and Bill had kept it a secret from Billy. When they came to him with the cash and the story, the man could not believe his ears. Whereas the entire world was admiring him for his great deed, Billy still felt himself unworthy of all these praises and love. "I like it, but I don't think I deserve it," Billy said. In fact, he was surprised at people's reactions. what I actually feel like. What has the world come to when someone returns something that doesn't belong to him and all this happens? Billy continued, I still see some of the same people, but only now, instead of coming up and giving me change, they're coming up, shaking my hand and, you know, saying, hey, good job. His honesty not only made him a hero, but also helped get him off of the street. The money helped him a lot in starting a new life. Not many people get this chance. He considered himself lucky and decided to use cash wisely. Billy contacted an attorney who suggested him to put money into a trust. The man now had enough cash to buy himself a vehicle along with the house. He will be doing the reconstruction all on his own. Well, this is not where his story ends. Billy was yet to get the greatest gift of his life. After getting fame and money, the man reunited with his lost family. His family had been searching for him for the last 16 years. They saw him on TV, and it's from there that they found him. Billy's family thought that their brother had passed away. Naturally, they were very much relieved when they spotted him on TV. Robin, Billy's sister, recalls how she felt when she learned that her brother was alive. I got on the computer one morning and I knew it was my brother as soon as I saw the picture. Robin lived in Wichita Falls, Texas, that was 500 miles away. Robin was more than happy about finding out her brother was back. We cried on the phone and talked about how happy we were that we found each other, because he said he was worried about me too. He had been gone so long, reminisced Robin. Billy Ray was over the moon when he saw his siblings again. I'm glad that we all got in touch with each other. I was really worried about them and they were worried about me. And there were so many stories going around in Texas that I was dead or in Arkansas and nobody knew anything. Billy Ray is in constant touch with his family now. Billy said, we're actually talking about having a family reunion. I can't wait. I got happy feet. NBC News was following this story from the beginning. And after uncovering so many good surprises in Billy's life, the channel invited Sarah, Billy, and Billy Ray onto their show to share the experience. Well, the trio talked about the heart-melting response and the assistance of the community. They started with the losing of the ring and how it changed Billy's life. All this time, Billy had no idea his family was backstage. The NBC reporter broke the news to him. He couldn't wait to see his family again. After the talk show dropped one more hint by telling him that Robin was not alone there. Along with Robin was his brother Edwin and two sisters EJ and Nellie. They all came together on stage. Billy Ray gave all of them a tight hug and tried to express his happiness in words. This is a really big surprise. I'm in shock. Nellie, Billy Ray's older sister, spoke her heart out on the show. We'd been wondering for years, where's he at? Is he alive? Robin said it means the world to have her big brother back in her life. She had tears in her eyes. Ray learned that he had become the uncle of many nephews and nieces. Edwin talked about his 14-year-old son who wanted to see his uncle. Billy Ray was smiling ear to ear during the session. He plonked down on the sofa next to Robin, and he explained, I never would have thought this. This is a total shock. He was seeing them after so many years. He wondered if he was dreaming. They were going to meet again in the summer. Billy said, I want to thank all the people that helped me out, and I want them to see where all their efforts, blessings, and kindness is going. Overall, it just makes me feel good, opened up Darling. She added, a lot of people came together to change this person's life when he is someone who really deserves it. He definitely seems like his spirit has been rejuvenated. He has the chance to express himself more, you know, to buy a new car and buy new clothes. Bill, Sarah's husband, took over from there. He's just a solid guy, and you can tell he's probably going to make it out all right. Now, not a day passes by when Billy Ray doesn't talk to his siblings. Well, the incident got Billy not one, but two families. Billy stayed in touch with Sarah Darling and Bill. The couple felt blessed that they could help the man. Now, the couple meets the old man every now and then. Bill respects and appreciates what the old man did for them, and Bill said, "I knew immediately that he was someone that was on the same wavelength as me, and I was looking forward to being able to go chat with him once in a while." Bill was eagerly waiting to tell Harris about the number of donations. He went along with Billy to get his bicycle repaired in order to tell him the news. Their meeting went on much longer than they had expected. Both of them were very happy about how the entire story panned out. Bill said, "We talked about a lot of things related to my family's ring and the many donations. We talked about how one day in the future, the ring may be passed down to my daughter." Bill told him why the ring was so important to them. It was not only expensive, but also a family heirloom that is passed down from generation to generation. Sarah and Bill have two kids, a girl and a boy. Sarah wants them to meet Harris. She's positive that the kids would get a lot to learn from him. She also wants to tell her kids how he helped them to get back her engagement ring. Darling stated, "I've talked to other mothers about this. It gives other moms a real tangible story of really teaching the difference between what's wrong and what's right." Harris told Bill that he finally has found himself a home that is safe and sound. "So, this is how one act of kindness can turn your life around. Who knew that Harris would have a house and a car of his own for only giving back a ring?" Harris said, "When I think of the past, I think, thank God that it's over. His past life was full of hardships and agony, and now he's extremely happy to have a family around. Now he can feel human." Sarah and Bill paid it back in the best way they could. Billy Ray couldn't believe his ears when the fundraiser started to gain traction. He explained, "I was almost scared to look at it then. I didn't want to get my hopes up too high." Billy Ray was on cloud nine when he got the money. "I didn't think it was going to happen in my lifetime. Being 50-something years old and being out of touch that long, you just figure you ain't gonna get in touch." The man knows the importance of money and so did not want to lose it again. Billy Ray hired a lawyer who would help him in coming up with wise decisions and dealing with his cash. Billy has bought himself a black Volkswagen Beetle and uses it to go around the town. "It's a 98 Volkswagen, which I kinda had pimped out a little bit," Billy Ray explained. "It's just an eye catcher, you know?" This unique experience has inspired confidence in Billy Ray. He has started to think big. He's toying with the idea of starting his own company once being done with his home project. He shared, "I'm thinking about getting a pickup, a paint gun, two ladders, and some other paint equipment, and doing my own paint." The man is all set to start his new life. "I'm still in the right here, right now mode. You know, that's the one thing I've never been able to get out of. Good luck or bad luck, it's like I'm right here, right now. Whatever happens, happens," said Billy. The journey from rags to riches was a difficult one for Billy Ray. He had spent 16 years of his life begging for change. The man had lost all hopes of finding a job and even his family. Though his life had changed, the memories of the past were still there. "At the very worst, I'm going to eat today, and I'm going to buy whatever I want to eat. And that was fine with me," he said. Life has taken a big turn. The man who used to beg at the plaza now goes there for shopping. He revealed, "I still drive through the plaza and basically see them. I actually stop and give them money now, believe me.